This probe is called the heart rate monitor, and it works a little differently than most probes because the actual sensor is separate from the interface for the lab probe. Now, if you have this probe, you'll notice there's a white arrow on this sensor, and on the left-hand controller, there's also a white arrow. This white arrow must be lined up with that white arrow for it to pick up a signal. These can be as much as 3 feet apart, but they have to be aligned. If there's another one of these being used somewhere in the vicinity within 3 feet, this could actually pick up the other one and get interference. So if you do have these, you want to use them, make sure that your students are more than 3 feet apart. Basically what this does is it's detecting a galvanic skin response between your two hands, generating an electrical pulse that is picked up by this device and then turned into a signal that goes into the lab probe. So I'm going to go ahead and hook it up and see if we can get it to work. That seems to be doing fine. You'll notice that the software has detected the new probe, and it has the signal and the heart rate. The signal is the actual pulse. So when we start collecting data, you'll notice that on the signal you'll get spikes, and if you're not getting spikes, you're not picking up data. The heart rate at the bottom is actually measuring the heart rate. Now, this works best with two students, so one student can hold this device so that it's pointed in the right direction. I'm just going to have to hold my hand to match it, and right now the arrow is pointing that way. So when I go to record data, I'm going to pick this up and make sure that my hand is parallel and see if we can collect some data. All right, I'm going to start the computer and let's see if we can start collecting some data. Found earlier today that if my hands are not moist, it doesn't pick up real well. I'm having a little problem getting it to read right now. So you may want to have the students wash their hands before they try to do this so that there's some moisture on the hands. And that's how you use the heart rate monitor. This could be used as part of the lessons on physiology and anatomy in seventh grade, where you're looking at different body systems and how they interact. So you could look at how the muscular system affects the heart rate, because you could have a student exercise holding these and another student sitting holding this close enough to get the readings and detect their change in heart rates over time. That's the heart rate sensor.